in little as 3 minutes, smoke inhalation can cause permanent damage or even death.
We staged an emergency simulation drill where the students who could use the stairs got out of the building in 3 minutes.
Our school, like many others, is a multi-level structure. When a fire occurs, students that can't use stairs are asked to shelter in place. That means they sit and wait until help arrives.
No one wants a loved one in a burning building any longer than they have to be.
Every year, 6,000 firefighters are seriously injured and 17 others lose their life in structure fires.
The two problems that we have is one, we need to get all students out of the building faster, and two, we need to prevent firefighters from going into harm's ways.
It took over 17 minutes for the students who sheltered in place to be rescued.
Our solution has two parts.
The first is an evacuation device.
We use Inventor, and it's a 3D modeling software.
The prototype that we're working on is a device to get impaired students down the stairs, and it's kind of like a wheelchair, but it has like a higher handle and wheels down at the bottom. And it's three wheels where they rotate to fit the stairs, and so it's easier to go down. We will have three adults in the building trained to be able to use the prototype in an emergency.
This eliminated 12 minutes of our baseline time of getting a person in a wheelchair down the stairs.
The app tracks people by their schedules and their mobility levels.
Administrators and first responders and teachers would be able to access it and check off if the student is in the building or not.
So our nurse will constantly update the app itself so that students who are temporarily injured can be on there, taken off as needed.
We're able to mirror information from our student management software, Infinite Campus. This means we have daily updates for things like student attendance, enrollment status, and accounts for new injuries.
What I feel like is the most valuable aspect of the project is the value of the information that it puts at teachers' fingertips. Smartphones never leave people's side, and crisis will happen in real time, and so with just a click of a button, teachers have valuable information that could potentially save a child's life. And because of that, I definitely plan to share this with my faculty at my next meeting.
Our app is in use and has been adapted district-wide. We have worked with principals in our district and have begun to share with other districts in our area. It is not that our school or any other was neglecting the need of these students, but because of the advancements in STEM techniques and technology, we will soon be able to say, no child left behind.